The American Cancer Society has released a pioneering report. Cancer in people who identify as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, or gender nonconforming. The first study of its kind revealed unique stressors and discrimination that likely increase cancer risk in the LGBTQ plus populations. And joining me right now, we have Maria Kano. Thank you so much for joining us. You're with the American Cancer Society, correct?
No, I'm actually with the University of Colorado.
Good to know, Maria. So thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.
So kind of walk me through about this study and exactly what this means.
So the American Cancer Society released a fundamental report that shows us some real gaps in care for members of the LGBTQ community. First of all, lack of screening among our LGBTQ populations, a lack of appropriate care and training for our medical providers, and just some disparities in terms of cancer risk prevalence and occurrence in the LGBTQ population.
Yeah, and why is this so important?
It's important because this is a relatively new field of study. Mm-hmm. Within the research sphere, we've only been looking into LGBTQ cancer health disparities for about the last 20 years. And so we have a lot of work to do to make sure to provide equitable care for members of our LGBTQ community.
Going over that report, what are some of the highlights that you noticed or that kind of like came at you?
The highlights, I think, really involve a lot of the risks in our LGBTQ population. Many stem from the stigma and discrimination that people experience on a day-to-day basis. Mm-hmm. And that happens in the broader community, but it happens as well in our healthcare settings. And so the American Cancer Society report really highlights those disparities and how our risk factors lead to heavier rates of smoking, heavier rates of drinking, and a lack of screening among our LGBTQ folks.
Yeah. So what is the goal what is the goal that you guys are looking for from this study?
We're looking at this study to help us create other studies so that we can create processes to collect sexual orientation and gender identity data for people on a national level. We have never been able to do that successfully, and we're really working on that now. That helps us to know what actual risk leads to prevalence of cancer and mortality rates for people so that we know what types of services we need to design to improve care for people. So this report really helps us to move that needle forward into identifying what the gaps in services truly are.
Yeah, and I know you talked about the biggest highlights from that report, but what are your biggest takeaways? Some of them were the screening as well.
Absolutely. LGBTQ people tend to not be screened at equitable rates. For example, Black men, as opposed to white men, have prostate cancer 50% more. Mm-hmm. And if you look at a Black gay man or bisexual man, they tend to get screening even less than that. So we have a huge disparity there. The same with bisexual and lesbian women have higher rates of breast and cervical cancer compared to heterosexual women. Yet some doctors tell lesbian and bisexual women that they're not at risk for cervical cancer. And we know that that's not actually true and that screening is really important.
And really quickly, before we wrap this up, if someone wants to learn about this report or about this study, where can they find this information?
The American Cancer Society has an amazing online presence where people can go learn everything they need to know about their screening and where they can actually access care. You can always come to the University of Colorado. We're doing a lot of work there to try to improve care for Coloradans. And then you can also go to the National LGBTQ Cancer Network website. They also have additional resources.
Thank you so much for being here and for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.